we're continuing our cocktails and conversation with Renae here at the Conrad, and we're just discussing how we're all adjusting
COVID
the pandemic.
COVID life.
Yeah, you know, I think here at the hotel, as well as I'm sure every other venue in the city and across America, just adjusting to the type of events and the size of events that, you know, we're able to host now, given all of the CDC guidelines, the city restrictions, you know, just trying to follow everything and keep everybody safe. We started 2020, like, everything looked roses and we were going to have the best year of our life. And it was going to be so exciting as a new hotel to really just celebrate, you know, going into our second year of being open and doing it, you know, so well. And March, what was it, 17th, 16th, 17th? Like, it just ended, literally. So having to kind of change our focus after that and really just focus on the well-being of our staff first and foremost.
Full disclosure, we all hung out on Zoom while you guys were furloughed.
Yes.
But how did that affect, like, you guys trying to come back and, like, getting from point A to point B?
It was, we all knew it was coming, but then when it happened, it was like, whoa, this is,
yeah,
this is real. We also were like, oh, we'll see you in a month.
Right.
See you in a month.
But then it just kept going.
And then I was like, oh, okay. So April 1st was my last day. And then I was out for 5 months and I came back. I was one of the lucky ones, September 1st. But still, we're at maybe 30%, I think, of our total staff, like hourly, manager, everything overall in the building. So our main focus is to just book business. Whereas before, we could pick and choose, so to speak, like not everything, but like, you know, you try and get all you can and like fill the ballroom, fill the hotel. And now it's just like, okay, what do we have? How do we get it? Like, it's a birthday party. Perfect. We'll take it. Whereas in the past, that may not have been anything we would even honestly like consider, depending on the size, you know,
kind
this
of
is
in
new
survival mode.
Correct.
Yeah.
Because we know, like, again, our staff is of the most importance. So if we book something, they get hours, they get to work. Yeah. And that's what's important.
Well, you guys are lucky though, because you have a lot of really cool spaces.
We are.
Like, this is my favorite space right here.
We're sitting in one of them, the Blue Willow Room. Yeah, I mean, it's so funny. We have these amazing outdoor terraces, which we clearly have always had, but we're like, oh, they're so small. We can't do anything out there. And now it's like, oh, perfect. You want to have, you know, a cocktail party for 15 people. You want to, you know, get married out there with 10 of your closest friends and family. Perfect. And it's like, we've done so many events on these terraces, which is like everyone feels safer outside. And our terraces are so beautiful and lush with the greenery and the lights. And it's such a unique feel in the city. So we're so lucky to like have them, whereas they were something that we really kind of took for granted before. And now it's like,
well,
and like amazing.
In here, it's nice because you can have a 10-person dinner party and it not feel overwhelming, like if you were in a ballroom.
Right.
Which
right.
is why, again, I love Conrad. You know, that's just me.
Yeah, we have a lot of unique spaces that we've been able to really kind of sell to the more intimate weddings and
yeah.
rehearsal dinners and people who are just, maybe they're getting married later, but they still want to celebrate with those closest to them. So this room has been like a godsend.
Are you guys doing anything special for like Christmas and New Year's?
The restaurant, the lounge, we do have some offerings. We also did, for Thanksgiving, we did turkey meals to go. So you could order your full Thanksgiving dinner. We're doing the same for Christmas. You know, chef often says like, we have a whole new box now and we're thinking outside of that box. So like, it's like, you know, everyone always is thinking outside the box. Well, we're not playing in the same box anymore. So it's like,
and the
what?
Box changes every week.
Every day. It's a new restriction, a new set of number of people you can have in a space. So, you know, we're all just adjusting as best we can. And really across the hotel, everyone is doing everything. Like, we just all need to chip in and kind of help out where we can. So brainstorming ideas is like a daily thing. Like, oh, what if we tried this, you know? And
yeah,
just kind of come up with something new and exciting that works in this environment.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And I think people just really crave being with each other. And so it's like, how do you satisfy that connection in the environment we're in? And
they
so
definitely do. It's like the longer we're all in this, the longer we just really want to be with people and see them and, yeah, you know, have these moments with them that are memorable and not just sitting alone in our homes.
Right,
trying,
exactly.
You know, to be safe.
We're seeing people on Zoom. I'm kind of over Zoom, but
right. It was wonderful during furlough and yeah. when we had to stay in our homes. But the partnership, you know, with you all, which I'm so glad that you're here today, but just all of our like vendors that are such close, you know, friends and partners with us now has just been crucial too, to get us all back to work. And just maintaining those really close relationships and knowing that you can pick up the phone and call somebody and like they'll answer and they'll respond. And they know, like, even though it may be for 10 people, it's urgent. Yeah. We kind of matching our values with one another and really kind of helping each other out.
Yeah, we're all in this together. So
we are.
Yeah, for sure. Well, thanks for joining us and thanks for hosting us today.
Of course.
It's so nice.
So glad that you could be here.
Cheers.